is basically one of the India's leading venture into student co-living space. They aren't much, you know, doing into this space at the moment, right? So Hooliv primarily focuses on the three-dimensional, you know, view of student co-living, which we say are the three different areas, like, you know, three C's, which is comfort, convenience, and community. That's what we talk about. And while operating in tier two and tier three cities, which is our focus area, what we are doing is we're trying to merge these three into one platform, which will not only provide students with a standardized living space, but it will also enable them with the flexibilities of, you know, making the payments with different models, then creating an ecosystem where they can collaborate on various assignments, projects, talk to different peers in the same, you know, hostel location or, you know, across the locations, and everything on their, you know, fingertip of the mobile app. So what we are talking about is not just a living, but, you know, you grow while you live in your hostels, right? And you be ready for the next journeys after your college. Okay. And all that, right? So, all this is not possible without technology, right? So if I talk about any of these collaborative platform, I can provide hostels to the student, but to engage them and to create an ecosystem, we definitely need a technology as an enabler. And that's what we are doing. This space is basically very niche, and it's a very vast space. So we talk about real estate bundled with collaboration, and then being provided as a shared accommodation, right? So we have got a flavor of real estate operations. We have got a flavor of transformation, transforming the current spaces, and then the customer relationship management. And then we also have an angle where students will collaborate, as a consumer. So if we see this space, it's a too vast a space. And Hooliv believes into the open source stack. So what we are doing at Hooliv is we're actually building the technologies in house. That means, primarily we are building these platforms. So for example, we are trying to build a platform where, the sales team can see how the property is performing, and the BD teams can see whether properties is profitable or not, and how it can be converted into profit. So we are creating different technologies merged together into one single platform, which we say Hooliv as a platform. And it uses niche technology stack of Alfresco, D3. Then we have got components from AWS. Then we have got components from, we are hosted on IBM software at the moment. So pretty vast area, pretty vast technologies that we are using. If you see our profile, I personally have over 15 years of technology experience, especially into the cloud technologies, and my co-founding team, they're pretty they have a vast experience into technology, so what we strongly believe that, nowadays the next set of ventures, next gen ventures cannot move to a scale without technology. And that is where we try to innovate almost every piece that we work on. I'll give you a simple example, right? Now in our domain, a BD comes with a property in some area, and then the beds are sold, right? The beds are occupied by the students. Now, unless we don't give a space to a BD to go and see how the property is performing, we cannot come up with ideas how to do better and how to price it better. So we have come up with models based on AI and ML, where we have dynamic pricing, not just by the location or by the hostel itself, but we are going much in depth and applying different rule set to give a better pricing to the consumer. That is one. Then similarly, if you talk about spaces like, if a student wants to collaborate on some project with any other student, they also need technology to be there, right? They also need some space, some forum where they can discuss that, hey, I want to do this thing, and is there anyone interested within my hostel or something close by? So why not we provide that? We're trying to provide a touchless check-in system, right? So nowadays, COVID is going everywhere, and so we are coming up with a touch-free or touchless access system where the students can check into the hostel without touching anything and making the payments, everything online. So we're trying to innovate almost every step what we are doing. Digital transformation is actually seen as a project, right? So if you go to any non-IT companies or enterprises, they talk about digital transformation, but they don't see digital transformation beyond just executing it as a project, right? So digital transformation, as per my experience and understanding, is basically a culture change. You know, it's not a project. It's driven by technology. It's a kind of a startup where you have to understand what's going on at every moment, and then you have to change your ways of implementing it at every moment. Okay, you plan it, but after planning, when you execute it, you will see different, you know, ups and downs coming into it. So it's more of a cultural change, which we as an enterprise needs to understand. And that is where, you know, from day one, when the Huli was incorporated, the focus has been technology, right? So we're not thinking of going for paper-based, sign-ins or paper-based check-ins. We're trying to be digital from every aspect, right? Another key challenge that I see is that every company has an IT budget, right? Now, it all depends what that budget which we have kept for such transformation project, right? So it has to be driven from the top to bottom, right? So my CEO or my chairman of the organization should know, like, you know, the digital transformation is going to benefit to them in long run. And that is where the culture change has to happen from top to bottom. Just like any other business, we do have an impact on the business, you know, an impact in terms of that, you know, the things got shifted by a couple of months, right? So we already have 600 beds on board, and we are building the technology platforms, right? And we are already having a culture of working from home in place, right? So that's mean, so we have mitigated the risk which is coming because of COVID-19 to our organization a bit. But just like any other organization enterprise, we do have an impact that the things have got shifted by a couple of months rather than having a major impact on us. If someone has gone for a property search or someone has gone on field and they don't have proper technologies in hand, then it will be difficult in a case of crisis to report the things, to report the outcomes of that visit or report the outcomes of something. So that has been one of the niche key area of focus for Huli, that we want to automate and we want to enable every employee of Huli in different departments with a set of technologies which they can leverage and improve the productivity across, right? So we are working with mobile apps for our BDs. We're working with mobile apps for hostel warden, which they use, from day to day. And, everything is on their fingertips. So suppose if a hostel warden needs to, you know, order some supplies, right? So they have the, you know, features on their mobile app which they can use if they want to report any kind of breakage or any kind of new work which has to be done in the hostel campus. They can do that. So similarly, we are enabling our employees from every department with set of fundamental features or applications which they use and they will use to better their work in terms of crisis. We are already tech focused, right? The entire founding team that we have, they have a very high vision on technology, that we are not only creating spaces but also the technology. So 2020 and 2021 will be primarily focused on creating the collaborations and, you know, enriching the life of students while they are staying with Huli at their centers, and then introducing AI and ML into various aspects, not just, you know, reporting or analysis. As I, you know, talked about certain scenarios like dynamic pricing, helping the transformation team to visualize, you know, how the hostels are going to look like. We're working on a number of such initiatives this year and the next year, and try to, you know, make this as a very innovative platform in its own niche.
For more updates from CXO TV, please like and subscribe to our channel.